video I'll explain how I created the Titan map effect from one of my videos. But before I start, I would like you to pause the video right now and tell me how you think it was created. Got it? Let's start. The first thing I did was to get the footage of the creatures from above. A friend of mine by the name of Jopulu created a gigantic custom map that basically only consisted of a flat ground plane. He then recorded all the animations for the creatures by facing straight down. Because the ground plane was either entirely green or blue, it allowed me to remove the background of the video without affecting the creature. This could have also worked with other colors, but the distinct green doesn't naturally appear in the game. This ensured me that no parts of the animation would be affected by the key. Let's fire up After Effects. The first thing I had to do was remove the frame counter. Unfortunately, Jopulu forgot to turn it off, but it's an easy fix. Create a mask around it and set it to subtract. Then use the key of your choice to remove the background. And apply to the other animations as well. Now I had to build a 3D environment for the animation to take place in. I started with this high resolution image of a map that I also used in one of my previous videos. This time it would be on a much larger scale though, so I duplicated it and made the images blend together using a mask. I also wanted to give it a more distinct texture. However, the source image I was using for that didn't match the resolution of the map. I had to find a way to scale it up without losing quality. With the CC rapid tile effect, you can expand the edges of an image. For tiling, I used the checker 180 degree option, as it looks less obvious that parts of the images are being mirrored. I used the blending mode hard light to blend the textures together. Using the camera tool, you can see what it looks like from above. Now that the ground plane was done, I wanted to give the environment more depth by adding an atmosphere. I offset multiple layers of clouds in Z-space above the map, so they appear closer to the camera. Then I used the puppet tool to animate their movement. However, clouds alone won't do the job. You can achieve a much more natural look by using fractal noise. As you can see, it looks very organic and kind of like fog in the atmosphere. By changing the evolution and offset turbulence values, you can create a dynamic animation without much effort. I duplicated the layer, changed some values, and placed it in a different position in Z-space. I then continued to add new layers of clouds, with different rotation, size and animation. As you can see, it already looks much more vivid than before. Now that the atmosphere was done, I could start placing the creatures on the map. I added a drop shadow according to the height of the creature. This desert titan, for example, has a much more diffused one, as it's higher above the ground. Then I created the animation path for the dinos. I had to take into consideration their distance, as well as default walking speed, to make their movement feel natural. I also changed the spatial interpolation of the position from linear to Bezier, so the path would be a curve instead of a line. For the Forest Titan animation, I wanted to increase the impact, so added a shockwave and changed the blending mode to lighten. You could use a different blending mode, but I figured that lighten would look the best. This is what the animation looks like on a larger scale. In the following, I integrated the other creatures, such as Brontos and several flyers. Asking why the Bronto is rotated, there's a simple answer to that. It was too large to capture horizontally, so we had to record it diagonally and rotate it afterwards. This is what it looks like without the atmosphere. For the text, I used Video Copilot's free plugin Saber and set it to layer masks. Now I know that I could simply set it to layer the text, but at that time I had problems to do that with a 3D object. Saber lets you create cool fractal variations, such as fire or energy effects. Here you can see all the individual layers represented as boxes outside of the preview area. Once I had animated all objects, I could start working on the camera path. This is just an example to illustrate how you can make it look smooth. As you can see, in this case the camera only changes its Z position on the first keyframe. You can change the temporal interpolation, which is how After Effects interprets the values in between two keyframes. Currently, it's set to be linear, which means that it will evenly calculate the values of the positions. You can see that the path is represented as a steady line in the graph editor. If my keyframe position starts at value 0 and ends at value 100, the value in the middle of the keyframes will be exactly half of that, 50 in this example. To smoothen the transition to the other keyframes, you can change the interpolation by pressing F9. This will change the line into a curve. By default, all position values of the camera are connected. If you want to modify the path of the curve, you need to separate the dimensions. Now you have handles that you can extend or contract to control the shape of the curve and thus the position values at different times. What the fuck, Finn? Why is the image not moving? What you're seeing right now is the real-time render speed at 1/8 of the resolution. You you can imagine how long it takes at full quality. So let's speed this up, shall we? This loop should give you a better understanding of the depth that this scene has, and that is actually a 3D environment that you can navigate in with your camera. So, how long did it take to render? Well, keep in mind that this is a 4K comp with a 60fps timecode. Most of the previews I showed you were at quarter resolution, and rendering that already took ages. Each of the placed objects is a full HD layer, and the camera is constantly changing position as well. I think the total render time for this part of the video was somewhere between 6 to 8 hours with the specs that I've listed in the channel description. That's it for this tutorial. I hope I could give you an insight and you learned something new. If you still have questions or suggestions, feel free to ask them. I linked my Discord in the comments and will gladly answer anybody. Also, we just hit the 13k a few days ago, so thanks to everyone for watching. See you next time.